Hey guys, it's your girl Fuzz and welcome back to another Stardew Valley video. I've been wanting to do this video for quite some time now and I'm sure you could already tell what it is by the title. So here are 10 mistakes that I see Stardew Valley players do all the time and how you can correct them to be the best at Skull Cavern. Let's get into it. Now, so those that know my channel know that I've already done a Skull Cavern video. Even though I don't go into too much detail with this video today is 10 mistakes that I see Stardew Valley players make all the time. And just in case you make them, I've got some tips that might help you get through Skull Cavern even more better. Number one, bring some food. I cannot stress how many times I've seen people go through Skull Cavern and end up dying to enemies they've never seen before. Although it's a simple tip to remind people, nothing in Pelican Town prepares you for the Skull Cavern. Be sure to bring a good stack of your favorite food. I usually go with a stack of 30 gold star cheeses to be sure to keep alive for as long as I can. Anything that raises your health and your energy more than half is a must to bring, even if it fills you up for more than the health and energy that you need to replenish. Be sure to bring your best food, whether it's cheeses or something you've created, and preferably one stack along with you so you have enough room to collect items in the Skull Cavern. Number two is bombs. I've seen a lot of people bring along a few amount of bombs, assuming that they're going to use their pickaxe more in the Skull Cavern. Although you may be used to using your pickaxe in the mines in Pelican Town, I have rarely used my pickaxe when going through the Skull Cavern. Bombs are super useful, if not the most useful tool to bring in your Skull Cavern playthrough. You can either craft them with the resources required, or if you're lazy like me, then buy your bombs from the dwarf at the entrance of the Pelican Town mines. You can access him with a steel pickaxe or with a cherry bomb. You can also buy some other useful meals to bring along your playthrough, but the bombs will cost you 300 gold for the cherry bombs, 600 for the normal bombs, and 1000 gold for the mega bombs. If your goal is getting close to or at least to level 100 in Skull Cavern, definitely bring a good stack of each, preferably 40 to 50 of each, and use the bombs at the clusters of rocks. Or why not bring 5 quats with you to trade them at the desert trader for a normal bomb? You can make plenty of chrysalarians, put them in a shed, and be sure to stack a lot of quats in them to just trade yourself some bombs instead. Be sure to use the correct bombs to avoid using mega bombs as they are expensive to craft or buy. Number 3, luck can be important. Luck affects everything in Stardew Valley. From the amount of wood that you get from cutting down a tree, to the amount of items and gold that you lose when dying in the mines or the cavern. Using the television and watching the fortune teller channel will advise you the luck for that day. But that's not all. Not only can luck affect you via the daily luck, but certain foods and rings can increase your luck even more. You can bring along foods like pumpkin soup, a 7 heart recipe received from Robin that increases your defense and luck by 2 for a certain amount of time, or spicy eel, a 7 heart recipe from George that increases your speed and luck by 1 and can also be dropped by serpents found in the Skull Cavern. You can even trade them at the desert trader for 1 ruby for 1 spicy eel. Only one ring will increase your luck when worn, and that is the lucky ring, a ring that is dropped as a special item in crates and barrels in the Skull Cavern and can be rarely found when panning in sparkling water. You can also find a special charm from Secret Note 20 which will permanently increase your character's daily luck by 0.025. If you're having a hard time finding ladders or holes in Skull Cavern, be sure to check the television first for anything better than neutral luck for the day, and be sure to consider taking in food that buffs your character's luck if you believe luck isn't on your side. Another tip on top of buffs that I see people tend to forget is food buffs. The game will allow your character to take on buffs from one food source and one drink source. If you've taken a drink that gives you a buff and decide to drink another drink on top of that, the new drink's buffs will take over the old buffs, and this is the same with food. I tend to avoid as much fighting in the Skull Cavern, even though time in Skull Cavern is a little more slower than anywhere else in the game. My choice of buffs is speed. If you've checked out my tips and tricks for the early game Skull Cavern, you'll see that my plan is to place down a bomb and wait for a ladder to descend. Speed helps me reach these areas to bomb and then get away from most monsters in the cavern. If your preference is also speed, I would suggest bringing along a spicy eel, as mentioned previously, and a triple shot espresso that lasts longer than normal coffee, and the recipe can be bought from Gus for 5,000 gold. Combined, you'll receive a +2 speed. Want some more speed if you find yourself fighting to protect yourself? Why not wear a savage ring given by the Adventure Guild and get a +2 speed when killing enemies? giving you a total of plus 4 speed for a short period after killing an enemy. If you want to know how I go through Skull Cavern and try to reach level 100 before midnight, why not check my previous video and see how I get through there with pretty much minimum items in my inventory. Number 5. I tend to see people go to Calico Desert with not enough time to complete the Skull Cavern. Be sure to go early. If you've unlocked the bus repair, the only time you can go to Calico Desert is when Pam arrives at the bus at 10 a.m. Even though standing in front of her prior to her leaving her trailer can get Pam to the bus a little quicker, you'll still be losing some time here. By then, you would have lost 4 hours in game for a total of 2 minutes in real time, which is 3.5 minutes in Skull Cavern. With a general day in Stardew lasting for around 13 minutes in real time, you definitely have lost some time to explore Skull Cavern. My suggestion is to get your hands on some warp totems to the desert. Either trade in 3 Omni Gyros to the desert trader or trade in 10 Iridium bars, if you've got them with you, for the recipe to craft them. Keep a bunch of Omni Gyros in your first playthrough to trade them for the warp totems, prepare your inventory the day before, and teleport to the desert as soon as the day starts. This will guarantee early access to the Skull Cavern for more time to explore. Be sure to also bring a warp totem back to your farm to avoid passing out in the caverns and to ensure that you can stay in the Skull Cavern for longer. Number 6. On the topic of the desert trader, be sure to check their inventory. You may be surprised what they might have available for you to trade. They will have a permanent stock to trade daily and will rotate specific stock as well. I have grown to build many crystallariums in my playthroughs to mass produce rubies for spicy eels that can be purchased daily, jade to purchase staircases only on Sundays to descend you down a floor in the caverns, quartz in the case that I don't want to spend the money to craft bombs, and sometimes diamond for triple shot express, which is a daily available stock. Definitely check the desert trader's inventory often, because you may be interested in some of their stock, such as trading emerald for a cheese on Friday, or trading 3 prismatic shards for a magic rock candy on Thursdays, which is definitely a late game food item to bring along. Definitely produce a lot of jades to bring a bunch of staircases with you to avoid infected areas and areas that haven't supplied you with a hole or a staircase yet. This is easier than crafting staircases with 99 stones, as this can be resourceful heavy. Or if you just want to make it to level 100 without the fun, why not just trade in 100 jades for 100 staircases? Number 7. I've seen so many times people going to Skull Cavern with an inventory full of items and then they're not able to pick up the really cool things that you can find in Skull Cavern. Be sure to bring what is necessary for Skull Cavern. I've seen players that leave Skull Cavern with a super weak sword, or a pickaxe not fully upgraded, or having the inventory already half full before entering. Be sure to only bring the necessities, even if that means making a dump chest or a chest specific for the Skull Cavern. My layout always has a sword, a pickaxe, 3 types of consumables, which are 2 for buffs and 1 for regen, whichever bombs I bring with me, and possibly either a few staircases or some stone, and that's it. It is important to note that if your goal is to reach level 100, try not to go out of your way for resources, as this can be time consuming. But sometimes along the way you may get random secret chests with really good items in there, or maybe you collect many minerals while bombing for a way to descend. I would also suggest to bring a gold pickaxe. You may not be using it much, but for the cases that you do have your gold pickaxe, is much more preferable as it breaks rocks faster than a steel pickaxe. Also, you may be using your obsidian sword from finding it in the mines at floor 90. This sword may take longer to kill your enemies if they swarm you, so either purchase a lava container from the adventure guild for 25,000 gold, or take a prismatic shard to the 3 pillars behind the desert trader for a great late game sword. Some people also suggest to take a slingshot with explosive ammo in it. I personally do not like this strategy, as the explosive ammo will only explode once in contact with a wall or an enemy. By the time you've tried using this, the bomb could have been placed down instead to find your way to descend. You can use other resources such as ore or stone on the slingshot, but I honestly think it's too resourceful heavy and isn't needed. Find your preferable inventory layout and keep trying. Number 8, which I think some people forget, I am also guilty of this, is to bring a good body kit along. Be sure to check the rings and the boots that is on your character when going through Skull Cavern. Some people bring in certain rings for their playstyle, whilst others sometimes forget what they have on. I'm not trying to call you out, I'm only trying to remind you that your boots and your rings are important to consider. Check out my video on a breakdown of all the rings that are in Stardew Valley if you're looking for a certain type of ring. There are definitely many rings to consider, and sometimes choosing in between them can be tough. You may prefer monsters having a better chance of dropping loot, so you might consider wearing a burglar's ring, Or you might enjoy three benefits that the Iridium Band delivers of glowing, attracting items, and increasing your damage all in one. Or maybe you want to hurt those enemies back that keep hurting you, so you may want to consider a Thorns Ring. Definitely think about the layout of your rings that you'd like to bring along, because they may make it all that much of a difference. Also, Space Boots, which are found in the mines at level 110. These can increase your defense by 4 and immunity by 4, which is perfect for the Skull Cavern. To those who have unlocked the Forge at Ginger Island, it's a good idea to consider combining your rings. I have a Napalm Ring combined with a Savage Ring to explode and boost from a kill, and an Iridium Band combined with a Burglar's Ring if you want an idea of a build that I have. If you don't have the Forge or Ginger Island unlocked yet, checking out my breakdowns of all the rings in Stardew Valley is a great start, and I do have my 5 preferable rings that I like to bring along with me when fighting in these caverns. Number 9, which might sound a bit confusing, but I see people do the opposite: ignore everything in Skull Cavern. I'm not saying to ignore every mineral and every resource that is in Skull Cavern, but your goal is most likely to either get yourself plenty of iridium ore or getting to level 100. Remember your goal in mind and ignore going out of your way for materials. I too have planned on going to Skull Cavern and spent more time than I needed by using a bomb in a space, walking to collect everything that there was, and then going to the next area to bomb. These little detours can all add up in the game. My plan is always use a bomb, walk to the next area that I'd like to bomb whilst waiting for that first one to explode. If a hole or a staircase was found, then I'd descend. If not, then I'm ready to use my next bomb on the next cluster of rocks. In the midst of this, if you have a magnet ring of any sort, including the Iridium Band, then collecting items won't be too hard to do. Be sure to only collect when in the process of doing something else to save time. Iridium will start to show up around level 30, but even more iridium will show up around level 70 and 80. This is your goal if you're trying to farm iridium ore, so keep that in mind. Number 10, don't give up. I know Skull Cavern can be difficult. As mentioned before, nothing in Stardew Valley can prepare you for Skull Cavern. But here you are, watching a video that has hopefully sparked a light in you to try again, this time outsmarting the caverns and those pesky flying serpents. Try again. Be sure to be fully prepared prior to exploring the depths of the Skull Cavern. You can be extra prepared if you'd like also by bringing more types of food, bringing more bombs, or even going through the slingshot route, which whichever way is more comfortable for you, keep practicing. Even if that means waiting for Pam to travel at 10 a.m. Figure out what is best for you and fight to the end. I promise you'll make it. I hope you've learned something from this video. Want to argue one of my points with me? Why not check me out live on twitch.tv/Buzzarino. I hope I have made you feel empowered, because you're just that amazing. I will catch you next time, guys. Take care.